Last year, I reviewed the beefiest capture card that I've found, the Datapath VisionLC-HD2, capable of 4K 60fps capture via DisplayPort. It was a monster with a monster price and generally overkill for any current game streaming needs. Today, we have a little brother to it, designed specifically for game streaming in mind, the VisionLC-HD2. Datapath is typically a B2B business-oriented company, but thought game streamers might be interested in the capabilities of this new low-profile card. I'm EeplesVox, here to make tech easier to understand and more fun, here today with the VisionLC-HD2, a name that's not easy to keep saying. It features two HDMI ports on the small PCIe X4 card, but instead of the typical in-and-out HDMI pass-through, these are both inputs. Slot 1 can support signals up to 1080p 60fps, whereas slot 2 can support signals up to 2160p ultra-high definition 4K at 30fps. Yeah, pretty neat. This makes for a very flexible capture solution. There's a couple potential use cases here. You could use it for game capture input and facecam input on the same card, which makes for a lot less system usage and setup hassles compared to the, like, 4 capture card setup that I currently run. Or you could put two game captures in at once for a dual stream setup or switching consoles or a game console and PC input, and so on. It's pretty flexible. You can use both inputs at once or one at a time. As video devices, they're just labeled as inputs 1 and 2. Annoyingly, the physical HDMI ports are not labeled, so I keep having to reference a little paper pamphlet that they included with my loaner unit. You might want to use a label maker or Sharpie to mark these, as only one port supports 4K input, that being the port closest to the computer motherboard. The outermost port supports only up to 1080p 60fps, but both ports can run 1080p 60 if you want. This is a tiny little PCIe capture card, smaller than my Elgato HD60 Pro. It even comes with a low profile bracket for small form factor streaming rigs. The card itself requires no extra power and doesn't have a fan, but there is one annoyance. To support the full bandwidth of both signal channels, this is a PCIe 4X card, meaning you won't be able to use one of the small PCIe 1X slots like with the Elgato and AverMedia game capture cards that I've reviewed. Most normal PC motherboards will only have 1X and 16X slots, so you'll likely need to populate one of your bigger slots with this card. The card works perfectly in software like OBS Studio, Wirecast, and vMix in Windows, and they have a Video for Linux driver package for it as well. It was super easy to set up in OBS, and I've done quite a few of my Twitch streams with this card. Here, my game console goes in one HDMI port for my main image, and my camcorder runs via HDMI to the other port for facecam as well. Super easy to set up. The first time I did try using this card with Twitch, I had a huge audio delay issue within OBS, but after a reboot, I've yet to recreate this issue, so just make sure you reboot. It performs well, with full uncompressed access to your HDMI sources and easy integration into streaming programs. Finding the card might be another issue. There's a couple general video gear shops that have it for around $600, but I can't find it on B&H or Amazon. I'll have general search links for those sites just in case they become available. $600 might be tough to swallow for a capture card, but when you consider the low latency uncompressed capture and the fact that it's two capture cards in one, it's actually a pretty solid value. This video is brought to you by TubeBuddy, the best tool you can get to manage your YouTube channel, update videos in bulk, syndicate to social media, and back up your metadata and more, all with this simple browser extension. Head on over to eposvox.com/TubeBuddy to download it for free and learn more. TubeBuddy! Download for free! Learn more! I love it! Would you use a dual input capture solution like this? Let me know in the comments down below. Like the video if you liked it, don't forget to subscribe, and I will catch you next time.